In this video, we are going to look into how to create this pendant for the resin filling. Are you ready? Let's get started. We are going to start with the top view. Let's use the command. It's Conic Coner Retangle command. And we want to snap into the zero, hit center and hit zero on it. And it decided how big of your pendant's going to be. Mine is roughly going to be this size, and I'm gonna bring down the mouse so I can have like cushion looking things. All right, so we're gonna do all the design within this area. We're going to use the command here is flat spiral, and we are going to pick up the center and coming in. And if that is too much turn or not enough, you can actually change in the turn over here. Let's say something dramatic like 10, so you can have something like this. I want something really minimal, so let me do 1.5 and let me do something like this. Okay, with this spiral, let me rotate it a little bit. I'm gonna creating the thickness for it. So simply I'm going to use the command called offset. It's living under the curve command, and you have this. I'm going to offset for 1.5 millimeter. So now we have something like this. I need to have this become metal. So this need to be connect. The command we are going to use is under the curve, and we have blend tool. When we have a blend curve, we have those adjustments that you can go ahead and try the best for your option. So now I have a spiral look like this. Let's go ahead to join them. I'm going to use that and use the rotate tool. Make sure copy equal yes, and let's copy this to the other side. Tweak it into the angle that you like. For example, something like this. And we're gonna use the blend command one more time to blend from this end to that end. One more time from this end to that end. So let's go ahead to join all of them. So this is one of the design right there. You can make it bigger or smaller or tilt it to whatever that kind of fitting into your design. Once I have that, I would like to have this have a wall, so I'm going to offset one more time on this one, and 1.5 will be fine for my design. I'm going to enlarge my design. I actually like it bleed to the outside frame, something like this, and let's go ahead to draw a big circle, maybe something like this, and another one over here. Maybe a little bit bigger. Alright, so now I have those. I'm gonna use the same command, offset. And let me offset over here and offset over here. Alright, maybe I'm going to move those two closer so have a better contact. Alright. All we need to do now is pick up everything, and we're gonna use the trim command to trim everything in the middle so we can have all the metal is continued in one single piece. Sometimes if you trim it wrong one, just Control Z, it will go back to one step, and maybe here. Okay, so it looked nice right there. As my design has a lot of point right there, it's not going to be good for casting any of the design like that. I always like to round the corner. Even something small like 0.1 millimeter, it's not gonna change the design that much, but it will round off those corner and reduce the casting issue that investment, you know, stay into those round corner. So let's go ahead to round all of them. And you can make them a lot more rounded if you want to. Let's go ahead to pick up the outside. Sometimes it's confusing and looking all this pattern right there. So let's go ahead to pick up the outside, and we want to go to the solid extruded planar curve. We want to get it straight. Let me make it straight up for 4 millimeter, and that will be the thickness. I also wanted to have outline as rounded, so I want to make the radius, let's say 0.3 millimeter on this radius, both on the top and the bottom. Okay, now let's pick up the rise of the curve, and we are going to move it up for 2, and let's go ahead to extrude a planar curve straight and over the boundary on the first extrusion. All we need to do is boolean difference, then we will get our design here. And that is the area you're going to fill in the different color of a resin. The rest of the design will be choosing your preference bail. Depends on what type of the cord or the chains that you are using. I have this color block here just represent the color for the resin. For your model on the 3D printing, you don't need to have those color block. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please leave a comment. Let me know if you like it or if you have other things you like to learn. I'll try my best to make a video to share. Thank you for watching. I'll see you next time.